We're going to check in on both campaigns. We begin in Cleveland, Ohio, where the NewsHour's John Yang is following the Clinton campaign. And John, I understand the Clinton campaign has responded to FBI Director Comey's letter.
That's right. As they flew here from Philadelphia, Jen Palmieri, the communications director for the campaign, spoke to reporters. She said, "We have seen Director Comey's latest letter to the Hill. We're glad to see that he has found, as we were confident that he would, that he has confirmed that the conclusions that he reached in July, and we're glad that this matter is resolved. We're told that the FBI, as they went through the emails that they found on Anthony Weiner's laptop, found that most of the emails were duplicates of emails that Huma Abedin, Weiner's estranged wife, had already turned over to the FBI. This story really threw the campaign for a loop when it broke about a week ago, and now they are very happy that it's been resolved."
John, let's talk a little bit about the ground game for the next 48 hours for the Clinton campaign. What can we expect?
She's here in Ohio for the second time in 3 days. She's going to be in Pennsylvania tomorrow for two more visits to make that three stops in that state over the past several days. What they're trying to do here in Ohio, a poll came out this morning showing it a virtual tie, Clinton ahead by 1 percentage point. They're trying to gain ground in this swing state, this state that no Republican has ever gotten to the White House without first winning this state. Pennsylvania is a state that they felt confident all along, but it seems that they're trying to nail it down, protect what they call their fortress in Pennsylvania, trying to keep it Democratic, keep it from flipping to the Republican Party for the first time since 1988.
John Yang reporting from Cleveland, Ohio. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Allison.